Here, baby.
What's that?
Hey, guys.
Sorry.
That's all right. In spring 2003, the city of Columbia, Missouri was having its annual spring cleanup, and it was encouraging groups to sign up to clean a stretch of roadway somewhere around the city.
Yeah.
It occurred to me that the Flat Branch Creek flowing through the center of Columbia could also use some attention. The creek ran adjacent to the MKT trail, a rail trail that I used really often, and I could see garbage in the creek when I would go running or biking along the trail.
Ah, the beautiful waters of the Flat Branch Creek. This is a pre-game look at a few spots we're going to be cleaning up today.
I was involved with single adult groups at both the Unitarian and the United Methodist churches. People in both groups seemed interested in participating in Clean Up Columbia, and I thought it'd be fun to get both groups together for this project. I forget the details, but basically there were some politics where it would be awkward to have one group or the other claiming responsibility or leadership, and the two groups hadn't really worked together in the past. So I created an ad hoc organization I called WATFOA. We are there for one another. WATFOA, and WATFOA invited these two groups to join in, and so we had a pretty good turnout. And in fact, one couple wound up getting married, one from the Unitarian Church, one from the Methodist, and they met through this group get-together.
Barbecue.
Kathy, say a few words. What kind of day did we have here?
I think we had an awesome day.
Yeah?
Everyone just pitched in.
How many bags did we get?
I'm not sure.
I counted 30.
Really? How many?
30 bags.
Cool.
I think it could be, like, priceless artifacts.
I think so.
Really. What you finding in there, Joyce? What are you finding in there? And I just want to say a word on behalf of latex gloves. It's just off goofing around.
Yeah, look, it's a great scene down that way.
Oh, yeah.
Pan down and look at everybody picking up.
We've made a lot of headway. I'm surprised everybody's this far along. It's good.
Yeah, good progress.
You know where the other group is?
No idea.
They're just this side of stadium. Half mile. Hi, Janet.
Oh, Red, with your classic, oh, you scum. I turn around, except I guess we're presenting you with yet another view.
So, Ed, what's your big find of the day?
Oh, I found a wallet.
Oh, the wallet. I forgot about the wallet.
Yeah, back up by Providence.
Where'd you go to the police?
With driver's license and credit cards.
Yeah, I forgot about that. I remembered the drum. I thought you were going to tell us about the 50-gallon drum.
Well, we had that, too. And we had a shopping cart.
You found a shopping cart?
Wow.
No way.
Kathy found $2.
Who's she going to give that to?
She kept it.
Oh, this is not a paid employment.
Well, I'm being paid in thread.
No, she did say she was going to buy lunch.
Okay. Perfect.
I have some black thread that I got just now.
Might be a little wet though, huh? Kathy, don't go in!
It's cool in here.
babies are you trying to get on?
Hi, Deborah.
Say what?
Hi.
Hi.
It's dead.
I'm interviewing Deborah, and you guys are chatting about a dead fish.
Yes, but we're not going to clear it away. It's going to biodegrade.
Where is it?
Behind you.
Well, maybe somebody put it there. Where? Oh, yeah. How? I didn't know they had fish that could live in this kind of water.
Oh, it died.
It died. Good point.
You'd rather put size, though, before croaking.
Yeah, well, maybe somebody just threw it in here. Maybe the head's gone, you know?
It looks like carp.
It does. That would be fitting.
Carp or trash fish?
Janet Stylin in the officially provided orange vest today.
I don't know.
You know, there still could be glass down here. I mean, I'm trying to step, like, straight down, so. Yeah, I mean, they're tough enough to. Exactly.
This is Ray in action.
Hilarious supervisor.
And this is the supervisor right there.
Work! Work!
My God, somebody armed him.
Oh, you are doing it.
Work!
All right, you guys, either we gotta go or we risk missing lunch.
You can give me my ticket, I'll go.
Say lunch a little louder. Lunch!
I just want to point out this is not the only garbage. That was not the only garbage our group got. They also put some down here at stadium. There's some bags there. I got some bags over there. I got some bags up there. We were busy people today.
So that was the Cleanup Columbia effort for April 2003. And a small group of us went back out in August to do some more cleanup, same spot. And a few diehards even went out in November to take one more try at cleaning up the creek.
This is Megan, and that's Kathy. And I forgot, this is me. I'm all set for getting in the water. It's 32 degrees out this morning, and I'm doing it. There. That's how I look. What you got there, Ken?
Sourdough pretzels.
Hi, Janet.
We didn't get as much of a crowd for these efforts later in the year. Cleanup Columbia was the big event. We also gradually realized that storms would come through and wipe away one layer of trash and deposit a new one. I suggested that what we really needed was some kind of fence or system of gates to catch the garbage upstream where it passed, where the Flat Branch Creek passed under Providence Road. Apparently there were some engineering challenges with that idea. So 6 years later, maybe even more recently, groups have still gone out, volunteer groups, youth groups, to clean up trash from the Flat Branch Creek.